All right. You know, you've always kind of portrayed yourself, presented yourself as a leader on the field. And obviously last year you were a captain. And, you know, obviously circumstances this year are a lot different and present a whole new set of challenges for anybody, especially someone who's, you know, most likely probably going to be captain again. For you, just kind of in terms of leadership, what kind of new things have you had to kind of bring to the table to kind of navigate the entire team and rally them during this time?
I think a big thing coach always says for the older guys is you lead by example. And I think when you're not with everyone off the field or on the field and you're kind of in different cities, it's kind of tough. So having to use technology to reach out to the guys, check in on the younger guys, the older guys you kind of live with and you've been around. So you kind of have those personal conversations off the field and group messages joking around, but just trying to have the team stay in touch. And we always say how important family is here. So having that aspect stay when you're not seeing everyone day in and day out, it's kind of been tough keeping connected. And I think I'll give credit to the coaches on that. They've done a big portion of just little things, just trying to get to know each other a little more and stay connected. But I think that probably just having that chemistry, and whether it's watching film and trying to say, hey, this is what I do, you can't really kind of practice it on the field. So just that kind of disconnect of not being with your brothers every day has been a little tough.
Jim Coyle, and then we'll go to Steven.
I don't know, a lot of guys have been asked this, but and it's been the same for everybody, every athlete in every sport, but beginning, shutting down, starting again, how difficult is that mentally to prepare, especially when you're on a team, a program that is truly elite, but has to do, I've seen the practices, do the elite things to stay that way?
Yeah, I mean, I think it shows the mental toughness of our team, that the kind of message that the older guys we were trying to send is, we knew Yeggs and them were going to fight for us to be able to still practice like we are now. So whether it got called 2 weeks ago, we were going to play one game and get called or anything, I think everyone's mindset is each year it's you're working towards December and a national championship. So this year you just got to flip a switch and we're going to work harder a little longer for May or whenever we can hopefully play for that last title. So it was just kind of realizing, hey, we're going to have to grind down a little longer, but the message we are telling everyone is it doesn't change for us. We're still coming and practicing at the same time. We're still doing the same thing. So it may be for a little longer, and we kind of took a day or two once it finally got decided. It was a little tough to hear, even if some people expected it. But I think it's just that mindset of it's just going to be a little longer challenge and road to a national championship, but we're up for it.
Go ahead, Stefan.
Coach Eagley talked a little bit about just kind of the new facility and how that's kind of a showing that, you know, the groundwork that was laid in years past is paying off. I mean, for you guys, how much does that serve as motivation to, if there is a season or whatever the next season may be, to make sure you guys are, you know, successful on and off the field with what you're doing?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. This university has rewarded us and done great things for this team, whether it's the travel we get to do or the facility or even the clothes and stuff. So even for alumni and everyone, for all the history, when you come here, it's not the fact that, hey, I got here, the journey's over. It's you want to leave a legacy here. So whether you want to put a picture up in the locker room forever and be a College Cup team, whether you want to put a star on the jersey, I think getting this new facility is just another thing that it's a great opportunity we've been given, and we want to prove that we're grateful for it and make it worth everything that's been put into this to show that it's going to make this team better.
Okay, we'll move on to Aaron. Okay, go ahead, Jack Edwards.
Spencer, you've been doing this for a while now, several years of experience. How has the last several months since last season in terms of physical preparation looked this year in comparison to years past?
Yeah, I'll quote Tom Morris, our strength trainer. He said it's uncharted territory, so I'm normally, when we come back, everyone's ready to get wrecked, and you're going to grind and put your nose to the stone and everything, and it's going to be a tough spring and preseason. But this year, Danny and Tom did a great job over quarantine and everything to get us going, but you can get the fitness and run outside, but just lateral movements, cuts and everything are tough to get back into it. So Tom did a really good job of easing our way into it and kind of listening to us and also pushing us at the same time of just protecting the knees, protecting the ankles, and kind of figuring it out. So, I mean, everyone came in fit, but I think it was the soccer aspect of you could get some touches in your basement, you'd play with a few guys, but just getting those movements back, it was going to be a little shock to the body. So we did a lot of therapy, yoga, stretching, and make sure we cool down really well. So I think it was just protecting the joints and getting lateral movement back. But overall, I think fitness and everything, everyone was spot on like we normally are each year.
Okay, does anybody else have anything for Spencer? Okay, thanks, guys.
Bye.
Thanks, Charlie.